Then I've used this big fat equation, this one.
2 times the arctan, in brackets, you know, parentheses there, times the height. So that's what's going to be arctan. Height of object in pixels, you're going to divide that, which is still within the arctan, of the height of the power in pixels. That's going to be divided by the 10.
G'day, didgeridoo. Welcome back, my friends. Grab a coffee, grab a chair, grab whatever you want. Let's talk some physics. So, today, we are looking at my favorite ever anime, Berserk 97. If you've never watched anime before, this is a good place to start. It's amazing. The first episode, you could probably skip it. Kind of takes place after the show. But, anyway, what was that? So we're making this video because I wanted to make some calculations. We're going to see if Guts could actually swing around that big sword, the Dragon Slayer. So there's a lot of calculations like this that are already out there. I wanted to weigh in and see if this can work. So I actually made this video a while back, did the calculations. I haven't been on YouTube for a while. So, you know, this might be your first video in a while. I'm coming back. So I'm going back to my PhD in physics. We're going to try and detect some dark matter. Speaking of dark matters, Berserk is pretty dark. So a little warning if you're going to watch it. Let me know down under if you've seen Berserk and what you think of it. So yeah, you know, just subscribe, hit the bell notification, and I'll be putting some videos up. So he has this really big sword. To the point where everyone in the anime is like,
there's no way that this guy could swing this thing around. Like, that doesn't make any sense.
Even in the anime, all right? So everyone's always making jokes about it. If you go on TikTok, you know, there's a no shortage of douchebags trying to, you know, train to fight with his sword or something. And they're trying to lift up, like, barbells with weights on it. But there's been a few calculation attempts before at this, right? And a lot of them say, like, 400, 500 pounds sort of thing. So, you know, quite ridiculous, but my calculation is going to be the best. Always wanted to watch Evangelion. Blackboard is down there. That's where it is. It's coming. It's coming.
Run! Run! Get out of here!
I'll die!
Ah. Oh. Glad you're here, my man.
Don't let her get away! Go after her and then kill her!
That man's invincible!
He ran his sword through the dub is really good. As though he were
amazing.
Eyes every time he swings his sword!
What should we do? I had no...
Make sure you stick around for the forehead reveal as well.
Cripple his left hand!
Goes a long way.
He won't be able to wield this huge sword so easily anymore!
Alright, let's get into the calculation, shall we? There's many reasons why I love the show. Many. It is incredible. It's the best display of masculinity that I've ever seen. Extremely, profoundly philosophical, existential. You need to watch it, alright? If you like my channel, you should watch it. I'll put the bit that I've already discussed from another live stream, cut it into this bit. So you should definitely watch the traditional video when I upload it to YouTube, because that'll be in here, and I talk about my opinion, how I think actually Griffith and Guts are probably actually the same person. It's kind of a metaphor. It's an allegory, the whole story. But you can look at it in the literal sense as well, which I also love. We're all here for Guts. So 903. This is the actual piece that I used. Now, it's kind of annoying because it's not showing the full, it's like gliding upwards. So you're going to have to take my word for it, right? But in this panel, which is a full thing, right? It shows you his full height. I basically calculated the pixels, which is very easy. You just go to a website, tell me the pixels, right? And so I looked up the pixels, and so I looked up how long this sword is. I looked up how tall Guts is, not with the pixels I'm talking about, right? So, because there's no really set information for his height, his weight, the sword weight, or anything like this, right? So we calculated it all. And so I've done the widths by the same method, the pixels. And there's the little tip down the bottom, which you actually could not see in this little bit, all right? Because that was important too. So let me pull out this blackboard, shall we? And we'll run through it. I used this exact panel that you can see
I can't be bothered looking it up because I'm not sure I'll be able to find it. But as you... Oh dear. Let me make sure this doesn't fall on my head. You can see I've tried to draw the picture, and you can see it's 633 pixels tall. It is... that's Guts' height, sorry. The sword is 550 pixels plus... what did I do for that last bit? 50 pixels. Okay, so then on the left... on the right, what you've got is density of steel, 8,050 kilograms per meters cube. We need that. We need Guts' height. So I've just said about 1.9 meters, right? I think it's like commonly accepted in, you know, amongst Berserk fans that he's probably 6 foot two. So that's the same height as me, right? But I'm just going to go with 1.9. Guts' height too, so the 633 pixels. Dragon Slayer width, the pixels here, 100.57 pixels. Again, you just take the panel on a computer, you dump it into a website that gives you the pixels, right? Easy. Dragon Slayer tip length. Dragon Slayer tip width. Okay, we need all that. All right, so this bit under it, this box here, number three, this is the weight of the sword. See where the third box is? I can't point to it because I'm holding a lot of shit. This one. So, all right, the answer. Let's skip the math. No one's here for the math, all right? What kind of metal is it made from? So I just assume steel. Let's just assume something like steel because it looks like, you know, human materials. But that's obviously, you know, a silly assumption. But we're just going to go with it, all right? So I assume steel. Density of steel, 8,050 kilograms per meter cubed, all right? So three, down here. DS weight. Again, skipping it, 255 kilograms. That is my calculation. I don't know. I'm just being dumb. So I think Dragon Slayer is actually about 255 kilograms, which is
not light.
I mean, I can squat that. I can deadlift that. I cannot bench that. So it's very heavy. So this is like my max, you know, close to my max deadlift. So to get how strong he is, right? I basically wanted to calculate the kinetic energy required to swing of the sword. My glasses are falling.
This is an absolute disaster.
I've got this. Don't worry. I've got this. In chapter 274, Guts basically was trying to stab the ground, stab the Dragon Slayer, the sword, the stupidly big sword, into the ground, right? As lightning was going to hit him, right? And the panel basically shows that he had to have stabbed it whilst the lightning came at him. But we can get the distance from the lightning to Guts by angular scaling the other character in the panel, right? And Guts, we take that away, and that'll give us an answer, right? And I can work that out with that. Serpico's height. I just assumed, you know, let's just assume average male height, which I think is 1.7 meters, right? So that's approximately, in the panel, 350 pixels, okay? And Guts in this panel is approximately 38 pixels. So the panel I'm talking about is the top left one there, okay? So they're both in this panel, Guts and Serpico. And then I've used this big fat equation, this one.
2 times the arctan, in brackets, your parentheses there, times the height, so that's within the arctan. Height of object in pixels, you're going to divide that, which is still within the arctan, of the height of the panel in pixels, that's going to be divided by the 10, and of that 10, 70 out of 10.
Are you with me? Did you guys follow that?
The Guts manages to move about 1 meter per second, right? If he's rising from like a crouch. And he's got to stab, you know, the Dragon Slayer into the ground. So the lightning travels, you know, I looked up how fast lightning is, right? So 4.4 times 10 to the 5 meters per second. We can account that, right, for Guts's reaction speed. And he swings the Dragon Slayer because he moves, right, as the lightning was hitting him. So that is the speed at which Guts moved, right? So 43,801 meters per second? I think it is. We have a velocity, so now we can calculate the kinetic energy and how strong he is. So that is that many joules. I can't tell how big that number is, but it worked out to be about 58 tons of TNT, right? And so that's the power at which Guts swings the Dragon Slayer, and that is 1.3 times the power of the Phobe. You know what the Phobe is? The father of all bombs. It's like the largest non-nuclear weapon ever made. Basically, Guts is like a walking nuke. So, that's Berserk. That, not very realistic. About 255 kilograms, the sword. And I think that'll probably be the video.